I'm free and I don't know. But sometimes I have a baby, person named Mary. An angel gave me and said, he must name him Jesus. Joseph and Mary went to Bethlehem. And there was no space for them to have him in their natural form.
They didn't find a hotel.
Then they asked the person and they said, I have a place for you to stay.
Jesus was born in a manger.
And the farm was empty. Animals crowded with pigs eat where the donkeys lived, and they put him in the hay. It was very small. And the angels told the wise, the shepherds, that Jesus was getting born with a star shining on baby Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. And the wise men followed the star, being shepherds.
People from around town bring presents. And birds, beautiful, gold,
and
good morning, and Merry Christmas. Thank you. In your bulletin, you'll find a corner. If you would take just a moment and fill that out, we would greatly appreciate it. It says members and visitors. If you would take a moment and fill that out, and when the offering plate is passed, we drop that in the offering plate, we would greatly appreciate it. We're delighted that you are here to worship with us this morning. And it is our prayer that you find this to be a worship experience. And we're worshiping the living God, God Almighty, who gave us His one and only Son, Jesus Christ. And that's why we celebrate Christmas, because it was the birth of His child that we celebrate. So this morning, we hope and pray that you find this to be a true worship experience. Would you join me in prayer? Father, we thank you for the opportunity to be in your house. Lord, in the peacefulness of the moment right now, speak to us. And God, as we go throughout this hour, let us hear the words. Let us rejoice through song. And Father, let us be reminded of the reason for Christmas. Lord, we love you and we praise you. God, may you be honored today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now the Deacon family is going to come and light our Advent.
Lighting a candle is a simple yet profound act. It is a testimony to the power of light over darkness. As we light this fourth candle of Advent, we continue our journey to Christmas. The fourth candle of Advent is called the love candle. As we anticipate Christmas, let us remember our loving Savior, how he came once as a baby, that the world through him might be saved, and how he will return in glory. The words of Zephaniah, the Lord your God is with you, the mighty warrior who saves. He will take great delight in you. In his love, he will no longer rebuke you, but will rejoice over you with singing.
How do we know that Jesus came in love and to demonstrate love? As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now remain in my love. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friend. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
And what does it mean for the followers of Christ Jesus, told his disciples in John 13, 34 and 35, a new command I give you, love one another as I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another.
In 1 John 4:19, it says, we love because he first loved us. Jesus Christ is the true reason for hope, peace, joy, and love in this season and forever.
Again, thank you for your prayerful consideration.
Tracy? Let's pray. Father, we come to you this Sunday before Christmas, thinking back 2,000 years ago and the time and preparation for your birth. We are astonished at the way you came into the earth as a humble baby and a very humble beginning. And that greatest gift that was ever given should urge us as Christians to give that gift to other people. And as we come now to a time that we give a small portion of what you blessed us with, we pray that you'll remind us that you own it all and that we're just blessed to have it for a short period of time. And we pray that you'll
Take the gifts that are about to be given. Use them for the upbuilding of your kingdom. And as we focus this month on the special Christmas offering, we pray that every dollar be given will bring glory and honor to you and bring someone to know you as their Lord and Savior. We thank you for each person that's here today. We thank you for the ability to give you praise and glory. We thank you for that greatest gift that was delivered 2,000 years ago. For it's in his name that we pray. Amen.
Back by popular demand. If you were here on Christmas tide, excuse me, on the Hanging of the Greens evening, you were blessed by this next special. So back by popular demand, Bonnie.
Bethlehem echoed with the sound of angels singing. Long before shepherds left their flocks to find a baby in the manger, the prophet Isaiah had foretold the miracle that would happen. He said, "Behold, a virgin will be with child and bear a son, and she will call his name Emmanuel." Every song we sing about his birth celebrates the name that means God with us.
Oh.
The angel told the shepherds, "A Savior has been born for you in David's city. You'll find him wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." The world desperately needed saving then, and it still does. So the word Savior has moved hearts down through the centuries. In the early 1800s, a priest made the refrain of a tender carol when he wrote, "Christ, the Savior is born. Christ, the Savior is born."
Thank you.
Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. He's the door, the gate, and the living water. The Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Lamb of God, and the light of the world. Our great high priest and the good shepherd. He's the Word made flesh, and ultimately, King of kings and Lord of lords."
For a world in darkness, frozen like a stone, light is breaking in a stable for a throne.
Thank you.
Is there a sweeter name to the believer's ear than the name of Jesus? It's comfort and healing, glory and majesty. We sing it in praise and we whisper it in reverence. It's the name we lift up today and the one we'll worship forever. Christmas is an opportunity to remember what happened that night long ago. But when the season ends, when the day is past, when the decorations are stored away for another year, what we have because of Jesus, our Messiah, burns as bright as ever. We can have peace with God because the newborn King became the Lamb of Atonement. We can have eternity with Him because the baby in the manger became the resurrection and the life.
His coming is a message of heaven's glory for everyone. Let's pray together. Father, we give you praise and glory for the celebration of your birth.
Though we attempted to sing like the choirs of heaven, I don't think we quite made that level, but we thank you for the opportunity, Father, to sing praises to you, to lift up your voice and lift up your word. We thank you for your son that you sent so many years ago to be our atonement and to be, of course, the living sacrifice. We pray that as we celebrate this Christmas season, that we'll get beyond the packages and the gifts and the trees and the lights, and then we'll get to the true meaning of Christmas. That simple, still night when you came into the earth. And we just thank you, Father, for living those years and ultimately dying as our sacrifice. We praise you and thank you today for the ability to sing praises to you, but we thank you even more for that gift on the first Christmas. These things we ask in your name. Amen.
John 3:16. For God. Because God. Because our God, Yahweh God, loved us, cared for us, reached down to us, gave to us His one, His only, part of His being to come to us. Because He cared for us. He gave us all that He could give us. So that whoever, not black, not white, not yellow, not red, whoever believed, had faith in, put their trust in His one and only Son, His very being, could live with Him in eternity. God gave His Son. Many years ago, His Son came in the form of a child, born of a virgin, because He loved us. He wanted to have a relationship with us. And He still desperately desires that personal relationship with you and with me. The only way you can have that relationship is through His Son, Jesus Christ. Jesus came. He was born in a stable, lowly place, for the lowest of the lows, and even King. So it's for everybody, because God loved us, and He still does. Do you have that relationship with Him? Do you know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior? Also in the Gospel of John, it tells us, Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, and no one comes to the Father except through me. Jesus loves you. God loves you. Did Today, on the Sunday before Christmas, churches are full. People will fill up the churches. And I'm telling you, some is because of music. I love to hear music. My own daughter said this morning, "Oh, is today Cantata Day? Does that mean you're not preaching?" "Oh, I see how you feel. No, I just really like music." Right. Churches will be full. Glorious melodies will be sung. And it's our prayer that lives will be changed. I'm just here to tell you this morning, in the simplest of terms, Jesus loves you. Won't you love him back? Just a moment, we're going to stand and sing a hymn. And it's an invitation hymn. It's also a Christmas hymn. But if you've got a decision to make this morning, don't delay. You know, God gave us the greatest gift ever, His Son. We're going to go through this Christmas giving gifts of kindness. But the truth is, the greatest gift has already been given. Have you accepted that gift? There's a difference in giving a gift and accepting a gift. What good is it if somebody hands you a gift at Christmas and says, "Merry Christmas," and you take it and you set it aside. You never open it and you never see what it is. That's the same thing as Jesus standing right here in our midst saying, "Please, take this gift of salvation," and you not being willing to open it. Do you have that personal relationship with Him? This morning is the greatest time to make that commitment. As we stand and sing hymn number 76, if you've got a decision to make, I'll be down in front. The altar is always open. Come, lay your burdens before His feet. Let's stand as we sing.
Thank you.
me say thank you for being here this morning. And hang on, Allison, stay right there. This young lady deserves a tremendous ovation of just thanks and putting everything together and making everything come so that we can worship our Lord and Savior this morning. Would y'all please come? And the choir. And the soloists, they did a great job too. And Christian and Bonnie. Now you can be seated again. Let me remind you of Christmas Eve service. I understand there was a little conflict I was not aware of in the messenger. It is at 5:30. The messenger, I think, had 6 and 5:30. I don't know. But it is at 5:30. It will be a candlelight communion evening. And so you are more than welcome to be here if you can, if you and your family. Spread the word. Love to have you here as we celebrate that night. It's always a wonderful service. And so let me encourage you to be here at 5:30, and that is Tuesday evening, for our Christmas Eve service. Also, this afternoon, we were supposed to, and I'm going to double check real quick right here, we were supposed to have caroling and s'mores and all the good stuff to say. Actually, the caroling was with hay rides. But there's this front sitting out there that says, you know, it's going to probably rain this evening. And so more than likely, we will probably need to just not do that, because it's bad to send kids out on a hayride and go caroling and get wet. So we will not be doing caroling and s'mores and hayrides tonight, just for the simple purpose of staying dry, okay? Pray for those who couldn't be here this morning. They would desperately want to be here. Just pray for those and reach out to your shut-ins over the Christmas season. And finally, I know there was supposed to be a golf outing tomorrow, and it is definitely a washout, so that is a no-no, too. So, anyway, by Tuesday, Christmas Eve, it's supposed to be sunshine. So there we go.
Yeah.
We'll all come and celebrate together. Thanks again for being here. I'm going to ask Allison and Tyler. Tyler, you never get the Pookie Bear. Would you come on down? I'm going to ask Allison and Tyler, they'll come stand at the door where I usually stand. I'll speak to them as you leave and as you head to Sunday school. Let's stand and be dismissed.